Well, for months, Indiana teachers have demanded change. Now lawmakers have an opportunity to address those concerns as they kick off the 2020 legislative session.
CBS 4's Kayla Sullivan takes a look at what schools should expect and other top issues at the Statehouse this session. Kayla?
Education, public health, and safety are on the agenda, but lawmakers need to act quickly to address all three. The goal is to finish by March 10th before the Big Ten basketball tournament comes to Indy.
To order.
With that, a very short session begins, and so does the teacher pay discussion, which started months ago. Democrats call on Republicans to open the budget for educators in 2020. With a recent forecast showing more money than expected in the state's surplus, here's what Governor Eric Holcomb says about the possibility of spending those dollars.
Stay tuned. You'll hear more from me at the State of the State address.
Lawmakers on both sides are committed to holding schools and teachers harmless for iLearn test scores for 2 years. Proposals to end a controversial externship have also gained bipartisan support. Republicans are prioritizing the transparency of health care costs with bills to create an online pricing portal and a ban on surprise billing.
If you have some transparency and people can begin to cost shop and therefore cost and quality shop, then maybe they'll be more cognizant of what those prices are. And we think that'll help some.
But Senate Democratic Leader Tim Lannon doesn't think that's good enough, saying, quote, prioritizing the transparency of health care costs without also fighting to lower those costs does little to help sick Hoosiers who are fighting bankruptcy due to unaffordable medicine, whether they know the costs up front or not. Lannon also argues the Republicans' plan to raise the smoking and vaping age is pointless because it's being done on the federal level. Holcomb says it's still necessary.
Ours also includes some enforcement measures that the federal bill doesn't contemplate.
Governor Eric Holcomb prioritized a hands-free driving law that would ban holding electronics behind the wheel.
Well, the caucus is trying to get their hands around that, no pun intended. And there's certainly some value in that.
He says they'll have a long talk about it, but can't say where they'll land.
I think it's going to be a quick session, being short and all, but I think it's also going to be productive.
Well, some of these bills have yet to be filed. The deadline to file is on Thursday. In the studio, I'm Kayla Sullivan.
All right, Kayla, thank you. Look-